it's been almost 8 years since Hurricane Katrina made landfall. The storm forced hundreds of thousands from their homes. Many sought financial relief from the federal government during that difficult time. But as WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf tells us, that help is now costing them more than they bargained for.
Amy Harmon joined the military in 2003 and moved to Belchase Air Station, where she lived until Katrina hit in 2005.
We were forced evacuees. We were told to leave the base, and at that time they had no disaster plan. So we were just told basically to pack a weekend bag. We thought it would be just a false alarm.
But it was not a false alarm, and Harmon was displaced for months.
And actually FEMA had moved into the barracks, and we were given 20 minutes to basically get whatever we could carry. I flew in on a C-130 to the base, and I guess that was probably about a month after the storm, and had about 20 minutes to clear out as much as I could of my room.
She returned in December amidst chaos and was made an offer she couldn't refuse.
They set us down. They said, look, you know, FEMA's given $2,000 to anyone who was a forced evacuee. If you were a resident of New Orleans, which we qualified for, and you were a forced evacuee, this $2,000 is yours. We're ordering you to take it. At the time, I took the money.
A year later, FEMA sent her a letter asking for proof of residency in New Orleans during the storm. Harmon was puzzled.
My home of records was in Gulfport, Mississippi. As an active duty military person, it's completely legal to be stationed anywhere in the world and keep your home of records wherever it's going to be.
Even more puzzled when she was told to repay the money.
So I started paying $100 installments per month. By the third month, on my fourth payment, the fourth month, I suppose, they were ordered not to take payment for me. They said I didn't owe the money. And I said, okay, well, am I getting any documentation for this? They said, no, it's just, you know, we can't take any more payments from you.
Years passed, and Harmon assumed the problem had been solved until the federal treasury contacted her this year, threatening wage garnishment.
I'm basically in collections for money that I don't owe, and they've added about $600 worth of charges on there for late fees.
Since then, Harmon's been going back and forth between the Treasury Department and FEMA, trying to appeal. Then last week, she got this letter from FEMA that said, quote, a congressional inquiry and class action lawsuit regarding the fairness of collecting debts led to a mandate that FEMA stop all collection measures until the matter was resolved. The lawsuit was settled. FEMA was required to reprocess all registrations for disaster assistance between 2005 and 2010 before collections could resume. The applicant's file was reviewed and her debt is valid, end quote.
I won't file my taxes. I'll quit my job before I do it. I'm serious. I don't believe in paying something back that I shouldn't pay back. This is wrong. I mean, this is tyranny.
And this isn't an isolated incident. WDSU has been contacted by numerous individuals with the same exact problem. Students and other citizens will follow up and let you know what happens. Back to you.
Well, FEMA contacted us late this evening and saying in part that their authority to waive the debt expired on March 26, 2013. After a law passed by Congress. You can find the entire FEMA statement at WDSU.com.